Hello and welcome. How are you doing? And next, I am planning to show you, my friend, that how to use Makita cordless impact driver. And there is really this tool. And now I like to give you information. And here is really your friend, car doctor Peter Finn. And when we purchase this Makita's tool, firstly, of course, we have to install in here battery. And battery comes in Makita tools in that way. And there is this protective cover in here in Makita style. And when I take that, and this is like, this purpose is to protect these electric connectors. And now when I install this battery in this my Makita, it is really easy only in that way. And this click sound means that now this my battery is ready for use. And of course, please check in that arrow that there is enough this electricity. And in new batteries, they are normally empty, like in that way. And that means now that I have to charge this my battery. And it happens so that I press this white button and then carefully this opens really easily. Movement is really smooth. And then I need for this charging, I need this Makita's charger. And it looks like that. And there is different type of chargers. And this is basic one battery charger. And now this light means that it is ready. And there are those settings that when this blink, we only looked at what it means. It is blinking and it means that it is now in electricity and ready for charging. And then when I take this my empty battery, I need to rotate that in another, like upside down. And then I install, there is arrow. And this goes really easily and smoothly, look in here. And when this battery starts to charge, now this light goes in that area and there is red light. And now we look at what that red light means. It means that battery is not ready and it is charging in that those two lines. And actually that one, this first one, because there is only one light and it is now charging in that area. And then I need to wait so long that this is full, and in that area there is green light and also sound. It is like music sound in like cell phone. But now when I like to show you that how to use that my battery, I let this my device to charge, and because there is fan, I take this my battery away. Because this sound is not nice in same time when I tell this device I charge this my battery later. But let's go to look that how this my device really works. This is really easy to use, and first one is that I have to install this battery in here. And now when battery is there, I can test carefully this trigger that how this my drill bit works. And next I need of course some drill bit. I can use that six corner drill bit, or then I can use this adjustable drill bit. And there is really many like Phillips head screws in here. Now I choose this Phillips head and I install that in here. And then I notice that I have in here a little bit better drill bit. Where is this locking device? And that's I install this my drill bit in this better one in here, good. And then when I have this my drill bit, and then I have in here a screw, what this Phillips said, I need to only check that how well these parts goes together, look. And this means that when I keep that my screw in here, and then when I move that my drill bit, and if there is any tolerance and movement, then I have to change this my drill bit. And now there is really movement, and that's I have to select new drill bit, and I test that in here that what is very durable and fits well. And this one in here, that one looks good. This fits well. In that way, excellent. And then I have to replace this my drill bit to a little bit bigger one. And this drill bit moves when I move that outer, this socket in out. Then I can install this my drill bit in. Look, now it goes deeper. Excellent. Now I believe that this drill bit works well with this screw. Excellent. And then when I install this my drill bit system in this my Makita, I need to install that in here and same time move this outer socket a little bit outer way, and then this goes in deeper. And I can check that is this tight and it is well and it is ready for work. And there is really this my testing wooden lock, and let's test that how this screws goes in here. And it happens so that I firstly press that little bit in here, and then I take this my drill bit in here. Actually it is better to keep in that position, and small movement, and then I press this trigger, that one, and then this my drill bit moves, and now we can see that this drill bit is moving wrong direction, and that's in here there is reverse switch, an arrow, and now it means that it is in reverse, and when I press that in out, we can see that now there is this arrow in front, in this direction. And now this my drill bit moves in clockwise. Look. Okay. Excellent. And let's continue in here. And there is my screw. And then when I install in here, firstly slowly. And now it goes nicely in here. And then, and now the screw is in position. And let's go to look closer this my screw. Okay, and there is this really this my screw. And now when I like to take that away, I need to change this gear. And now it is line is in that direction. And now it means that now this my drill bit rotates to anti-clockwise loop, and it means that I can open this screw, and now we can see that if I don't keep that my hand in here, then this screw opening is difficult, and that's I need to keep that out, and in slow speed now this screw opens nicely, and there is this my screw. And then, how about then, if I like to install a little bit bigger screw, like in that one. And let's do that next. And now I need to also replace this this drill bit to bigger. And there is this golden drill bit. And when I install, I check firstly that how they goes together. Looks good, and now I take this my old drill bit away, so that I move that locking pin in a little bit away in here, in that way. And now it opens, and then I install this my drill bit in here, and first that one open, and then inside in here. And then, of course, now rotation is another direction. Now it goes in front. And then I take this my screw and in carefully. Firstly, this is important that it goes firstly slow. Now it is in there, and then when I install that totally, I can press a little bit more gas and trigger, and now screw is in here. And let's go to look that closer. And now we can see that screw is in there, and then when I like take that away, I change rotation, and now this tool works like reverse. And then when I take that out, firstly slowly and then fast, and now tool and screw is away. Excellent. And then what else I can do? There's thing that I can also use this my tool, like bolt this. I can use this this device so that I can install in here this socket in that way, that I can open these car parts. This is standard socket, 10 millimeter nuts, and when I install this socket in this my drill bit, then I can use this my tool like in also this car bolts and nuts opening. And let's look that there is, I need now I need this specific socket. Look, it looks like that one, and this socket fits, and this drill bit fits to this socket in that way. Look, and now they are like connected, and then when I install this socket in my Makita driver, I take firstly that away, and then I install this my drill bit in here, and let's look that in what position. Now I need this adjusting tool, and now I install this in here, and now I have this 10 millimeter socket in my tool, and I can open and close this car 10 millimeter nut, and this is really useful. And that kind of information, my friend, that how to use Makita impact driver. And then of course in that Makita there is thing that I have, if I have hard and stuck nuts, I can choose in this trigger in here that there is opening this program, that this opens these nuts really easily. Look, only that, when I press, there's only one pulse. Look. And that means that it takes only this bolt away. Look, if there's something. And let's look that how it really works, because this is really, really useful device and this feature. And now when I install this my screw in this back, and when I install this screw in here in that way, and now it's like in position, and then when I choose this opening program, now it is in here, you can see this red light, and I choose this reverse, it is only one pulse. Look, and let's look at how it really works. And now when I open nut or screw, it is only that way. Look, and then I need to press this again, and this is nice for opening these tight nuts and screws. Okay, and there is like basic, my friend, for this Makita screwdriver. And please enjoy and be happy, and I can recommend this product to you, and see you in next movie.